Hi guys, I'm Tatiana, and this channel is about data science, data analytics, and a career in tech industry. Welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'll share example of business question that I was asked during one of interviews in tech companies, and tell you true story how I almost failed this interview. I decided to make this video in order to review my mistakes. So I explained my answer, how the interview was going, and how I should have answered to pass this interview. The approach which I offer you in the second half of this video should help you to solve similar problems. So keep watching this video if you want to prepare to business case interviews and you desire to get a job of your dream. I started this video with an explanation, what is business case interviews? Business cases are very popular in strategic consulting firms such as McKinsey, BCG, Bain. However, they are also an important part of selection process at companies in other industries, especially for analytical positions in tech companies. By the way, are you guys being interviewed in some companies at the moment? Please write in comments which roles and which industries you consider. Where would you like to work? Case interview is a job interview with business contents. You will interact with interviewer to analyze and hopefully to solve case studies of business problems. In about 30 minutes, depending on firms and interviewers, you will replicate the course of actions that real workforce do in real projects to solve the same business problem. Business case differs a lot from technical question. You don't need to apply specific algorithms and models. You don't need to show deep knowledge in machine learning and statistics. Roughly speaking, it's required that you offer top-level steps to solution, and then with assumptions made and details provided by interviewer, get this best solution. You should understand that business case is not an abstract question that is asked to frighten interviewees. Business case is a real problem that is related to daily work. So it would be very beneficial for you in understanding details of your future work. During one of business interviews, I was asked the following question. Senior executive at taxi aggregator saw on the dashboard an increase of average time to arrival by 3 minutes this week versus last week. He comes to you with this concern. What would you look at? When I was asked this question, I expressed my emotions first and said, oh wow, what a huge change. Then I started to give possible reasons in random order. From my experience working for a taxi aggregator, I knew for sure that undersupply leads to increase of time to arrival. And I offered metrics to check if there is problem with the supply. Then I mentioned that there could be some change in marketplace in general, not just in supply, and assume that over demand also could lead to increase of time to arrival. After that, I waited and expected that interviewer will say, okay, let's move to next question. However, he wanted to get a full answer that covers all aspects of the problem. And he gave me a hint and said, okay, assume now that there is no change in marketplace. What else reasons can cause an increase of time to arrival? This hint actually helped me, and I offered a few more hypotheses. There was a change in algorithms and system started to look for a car in larger radius, or company started to promote new features that influence choice of car not with the minimal time to arrival in radius. For example, we want to promote cars with brand sticker and we promise drivers a priority, meaning that car with brand sticker is assigned to trip. Nevertheless, another car in radius without brand sticker has a smaller time to arrival. When I fell silent, interviewer repeated the question and asked me to provide 1 minute speech to answer questions. What would you look at and in what order would you do it? I answered that there could be a problem with marketplace. I would look at balance metrics, number of cars. Secondly, there could be a change in system, increase of radius, promoting new features. And thirdly, I took a pause and I was thinking, 3 points are definitely better than just two, and answered. And thirdly, I would look at seasonality and competitors, and I would look at it after the first point if there is problem in supply. Then we switched to another question. And I was glad that I proposed some answer, but I didn't like its structure. I felt like there are other possible reasons that I didn't cover and I didn't provide the full answer. Now let's review my mistakes together. So mistakes number one, I didn't clarify the task, the business case. It's a good idea to ask clarifying questions right after the task was given. In this particular business case, such questions can be, does this problem relate to particular area, particular region and city, or particular hours and specific class? Clarifying questions help you localize original problem from the beginning. Mistake number two. I didn't have a big picture. And after the task had been given to me, I ran directly to some random hypothesis. It is important at the beginning to imagine the whole system and processes in it. You can describe them aloud, that helps interviewer to understand your thinking properly. Rider ordered a taxi. Then platform is searching for a car in some radius of this rider. System calculate ETA, which is estimated time to arrival, for each car. This value means time that the driver would spend on driving to the client if he or she is assigned to complete this trip. To optimize time, the platform chooses a car with minimal ETA. After a car is defined, this trip is offered to driver. He can accept it and can reject the offer. In the second case, platform starts to search for a car again, and it continues till some driver accepts the trip. Let's name this driver a performer. When it happens, the performer starts to drive to a rider and eventually reach a rider. My mistake number three, I jumped directly to random hypotheses and didn't take time to think. I answered like I was in TV show where participants need to answer to maximum number of questions per 1 minute. It's important to take time to reread the question, to clarify it for yourself. And then it helps you to generate hypotheses and get a full, well-structured solution. In our case, time to arrival is a time spent by driver after assignment to the trip until he reaches rider location. Likely, you come up with several hypotheses such as number of cars has decreased, routing has been broken, or something like that. But is there any other reasons? To ensure that your approach covers all aspects of the problem, you need to structure your steps. My mistake number four is that I didn't have any structure, and I got it in the end when interviewer asked me to do this. I offer you to draw root cause tree right after you clarify question. Imagine the whole system and its processes. Reread the question and think a bit. In theory, tree starts from apparent problem. Then there are several symptoms of this problem. Each symptom can have a few possible causes. One of the possible causes is actual cause that leads to the root problem. Tree leaves at each level of symptoms, level of possible causes, should be mutually exclusive and collectively exhaustive, which means that they cannot happen at the same time and no other leaf is possible at this level. Let's now apply this approach to our case. Apparent problem is an increase of time to arrival. Next leaves are obtained after question. Is there an increase of delta between time to arrival and expected time to arrival of performer? expected time to arrival here means time to arrival defined at stage of choosing a performer. Remember that system chooses a driver with a minimal time to arrival among others in radius. Yes answer to this question means that there are some problems with estimation. Possible causes for this could be increase in share of drivers and riders locations with errors, increase in share of routes with errors in distance, increase in share of routes with errors in time. All these possible causes have corresponding bugs in the system. No answer means that the system estimates time to arrival correctly. Now I need to add one more naming. Let's name process of finding a candidate. Candidate is a car with minimal estimated time to arrival as a search attempt. So no answer generates several leaves. One of them is the question either increase in share of search attempts where winner doesn't have minimal estimated time to arrival. And this leaf has possible causes such as increase of bonuses or increase of number of cars with the bonuses. Here I refer to my example of promoting brand stickers. Bonuses which allow cars without minimal estimated time to arrival get a trip because of priority. Another leaf for no answer is the question either increase in number of attempts of search per request. Here possible causes can be decrease in acceptance rate. Here acceptance rate is a share of accepted offers in total offers. So how often driver accept or reject offer which is given by system. And the third leaf of no answer is the following question. Is number of cars in radius decreased? And here there are a few possible leaves also. One of them is a question, does number of cars decrease in overall because of competitors or seasonality? And was radius increased? For example, request in suburbs with a high ETA increased because of this change in radius. Please keep in mind that tree shouldn't be too high and 2-4 layers are enough. Okay, let's switch back to my mistakes. And mistake number 5, I didn't have any questions about my hypothesis. After a tree has been drawn, it's a time to ask questions in tree from your interviewer. Step after step, leaf after leaf, you localize the problem and find a root cause. Mistake number 6, I was asked to provide a speech. But it's a good manner to offer it before interviewer will ask it. So after you find a root cause, you need to summarize everything you get know. Mention top players of tree and then go to cause itself. Especially for you, I write full list of my mistakes and instruction right in the description of this video. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you like it. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, Data Driven Thinking, and see you in next videos.